Development, specifically in the Committee of Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, as the committee and oft wrote in the Uganda National Bureau of Standards, UNBS. The standards body exhibited low standards of management as the board chairman, Charles Musekuro, went gloves off with the executive director, David Livingstone Ebiru, as the two traded wild accusation against each other.
Eating and stop witch hunting, because we are all one family. This thing is not going to get us very far.
Ebiru, who earlier confessed that the board chairman put him on ransom and bribed him with 100 million shillings to retain his job, shocked the committee when he retracted the statement, saying he has reconciled with his boss.
One of the statements I made during the Hale days of our exchange was really over-publicized. When we were both attacking, both sides attacking. So I wanted to take this opportunity to inform you, Chair and members, that that exchange has ended in reconciliation or harmony.
Mr. Ebiru and I are not enemies. There is nothing we can clash on. What we are doing is in the best interest of the organization and of this country. We have a very big mandate to serve this country, the public.
In the House, legislators called upon the government to improve the appalling state of juvenile rehabilitation and remand centers across the country. The call followed a report by Equal Opportunities Committee, ALIEC, which highlighted poor living conditions in the remand centers for children and Kampiringisa Rehabilitation Center where juveniles are detained.
Reports of our visit to Kampiringisa, which is the only juvenile prison in this country. And I also need to make this house know that they are in a very bad state, the children who are there.
The state of this rehabilitation center is really alarming. And it is at this point that I want to ask government whether it is still has the capacity to take care of these centers or they are just there for formality.
There is a remand home in Mbale, and when I visited that remand home, Right Honorable Speaker, it was in an appalling situation, and we had to contribute for food.
In delivering social services, we need to pay attention to the quality of care accorded to the children. Public facilities such as schools, that is where you talk about education, hospitals, that's where you're talking about health. And then the recreation centers should ensure safe space for children where it is necessary.
We have 9 remand homes and 1 national rehabilitation center. And we have 1 which is under construction in Moroto, which is not yet complete, but it is being constructed.
The newly elected Member of Parliament for Oyam North, Dr. Apio Otuke Yunis, took oath this week to become the 10th Uganda People's Congress UPC legislator in the 11th Parliament. Otuko takes over a seat that fell vacant following the demise of Honorable Charles Engole, who also served as a State Minister for Labour.
I, Yunis Otuko Apio, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will give faithful service to this Parliament and support and uphold the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda as by law established. So help me God.
The House had a heated debate on unspent balances, which are swept back to the consolidated fund at the end of the financial year. Speaker Anita Among registered disappointment with failure by some ministries, departments and agencies to effectively utilize their budgets is an indictment on the planning factions at various levels. The House learned from the Prime Minister, Robin Anabanja, that the President issued a directive that the money returned to the Consolidated Fund should be returned to the respective entries in the first quarter of the next financial year.
Ask the Committee of Finance to do this House a favor and look at a statement of that account on the 30th June, how much money was there? Then I want also a statement on the last day. I want us to reconcile that account. let's have the statement before the sweeping, and then the statement after the sweeping.
Serious issue that is causing this sweeping back of these funds. One, let release. Then two, we also have now a common issue related to capacity building.
As a way of addressing this matter, now that the learned attorney general is here, senior counsel Chiriwa Chiwanuka, we should seriously consider looking into reforming the Public Finance Management Act.
We had a meeting chaired by the president himself, and he directed that the monies that are swept to the consolidated fund should be returned in the first quarter of a financial year.
The long week of parliament ended in protest as the speaker, Anita Among, suspended parliament sittings to an unknown debt over the impasse of local council elections. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.